Yes, and in our tandabuzo, but Jango when you tanda namdengo manani, I tanda gujalo, that lelenko siyami. Yes, we are on Born to Lead, which is your show every time, all the time, anytime, throughout. And I was just trying to connect the things up above Takabala Pekaya so that those who normally want to see me, they would see me as well. I remember when we were at school, Utishala wait Kangaba into Yakuyamberongo, Apale into it see me. Netubone is exercise Pukiako, Ibuya is it to see me or Konbakwehu, Uzaulitula Eladin Abisayo, I Kolendo, Ungayanzanga Gendela, Bulindere Uba, Uyenzengayo. Now I know that because we are on a radio visual KNR, a radio according to you, the program is Born to Lead. My name is Siza and I will be your host. It's a high voltage program. Every Sunday, you will definitely not regret that you have tuned in. You can switch off your heater. It will warm you like nobody's business. Let me begin by relaying our gratitude. Apa kwesibini besilapha man Ulestam and Kwakunye no Spoki and with their beautiful, lovely voices and get real. Truly speaking, I love watching them and I'm so addicted to their show that when I don't see them, I get troubled and I feel a bit unhappy. You know, Lester no Spoki, I want you to know that you are my heroes, guys. You inspire me. I love you to the moon and back and continue doing the good work that you do in this station. May God continue to bless, to enrich you, and to multiply you, and may you prevail. You know, beginning from next month, you do know that after my show, an angel will come and sit where I'm sitting. You know, I thank God for this. An angel straight from heaven will come and sit where I am sitting. Yes, my angel will be here and will be actually talking to you things that are directly from God. Don't miss these two shows, Born to Lead and the show that will follow it. Come October, you will be so excited that we have done so. And get ready, prepare. When that time comes, because you will love every moment of it. I will begin to introduce my angel that time. You'd abandon the abandonment, Gabriel Betu. Don't worry about which angel. You know, it's the one that actually is above the archangel. All right. Now, let us get to the grips of our show. I want us to talk today very quickly in about 30 minutes on a subject that is very important. It becomes the lesson for us today. Remember, on our show, Born to Lead, we take up a leadership lesson and we drive it very powerfully over some few moments, and then we make people learn one or two things in the evening on a Sunday around leadership. But today we will make it a double feature because we need to end with some word of God just to become an evening service for those who missed getting to the church. Get ready, the church is here with you. We will be with you immediately after we are done with Born to Lead. But let us start with Born to Lead. All right. Let's pick up a lesson that says, you know, something that you can do which can literally impact and change your life, but it does not need any talent. Things that do not require a talent. We want to talk about things that do not require talent. I know the very same topic can confuse some of you who are listening to me. They can begin to doubt, I wonder this old man, what does he want to tell us? Is he here to minimize talent? But I want to tell you that the purpose of our talk tonight is not to minimize talent, but it is to emphasize those things that are not dependent on talent, yet when practiced, they add value to others and they add value to yourself. Because I'll tell you, in reality, I love talented people. You know, talented people cause me to always marvel at their giftedness. You know, particularly those that can sing so beautifully and those that can do a number of other things in life that literally make an impact and add value to our lives with precision, ability, and talent. I love that, you know. Therefore, I marvel at their giftedness and I usually realize their contribution to society. Yes, and I must tell you that and I often sense the gap between them and me. Every time I look at myself and I look at talented people, I could easily see the gap that exists between me and these talented people. But I want to speak to you today about the things that do not need talent, because I want to, I see, unokwindla uqhamela ngahle nguyandiswa ke lowa beno faith phaya efonini yami, because I have tuned my phone to Facebook live as well at the same time as KNR live presentation. I just wanted those people who normally battle to tune into KNR. This is the last time that you are on my phone. Next time you need to come to KNR so that all of you are right in front of me and I see you on my screen here as I speak. I don't want to keep on looking on the side to check. I don't want to keep on looking on the side. You must all come up and lie in front of me. And this is the last time I give you the benefit of watching my show from a sideline, a sidekick, my phone that is on the outside. All right. There's something that I normally refer to as a high jump principle. Yabona xa ndithetha nge high jump principle, this is what I actually mean. Please listen to me. The high jump principle, to do a high jump, you need one person who can jump 7 meters. You don't need 7 people who can jump 1 meter each. No, some jobs won't get done by throwing more people at them. These tasks require talent more than numbers. That's what I'm trying to say when I speak of how I marvel at talented people. Sometimes attach their success to their talent. There are quite a lot of people. You know, when I think of that guy in the United States who was very good at, is it basketball or baseball? The book that, the sport that they play most in the US, I think it was called Michael Jordan. He was so talented. When I think of that guy when we grew up who was so good at tennis, who was called Arthur Ashe, you know, and maybe Gary Player, I marvel at their success. And I think that their success is attached to their talent. You know, there are two kinds of talent. There are man-made talent and there are God-given talent. Let's agree on that. Man, whether you don't or you want to, that's the truth of the matter. There is a man-made talent. There is a God-given talent. Yes. With the man-made talent, you have to work very hard. With the God-given talent, you just touch it up once in a while because it's a God-given one, you know. But a man-made, go to the gym, exercise, train hard, work hard for a God-given talent. But let me stop making this kind of introduction. Comfortable enough so that I talk to you, because we are now running on our show. Now, I want to talk to you the things that you do not require talent. I might mention 5 or 6 and then I am done. Madam, welcome, Lavi. I can see walking in, crawling up on that phone of mine. And I've said this is the last time I have an audience that is looking me on the side. You know, you will come up front on KNR live streaming, either on YouTube or on Facebook. And just punch www.knr.co.za and then you will see me there all the time, anytime, every time. And then we begin to work together on the show. All right. Now, let us talk about things that do not require talent. The first thing that does not need talent is what I call teachability. Teachability does not require any talent. I can tell you the second thing that does not require talent is initiative. For you to take initiative, you don't need a talent. And the next thing that I think does not require a talent is passion. You know, passion needs no talent. And what else can I say, man? The fourth thing that I can mention that does not need talent is courage. Courage does not need a talent. And maybe I will mention the fifth one. The fifth thing that does not need a talent is encouragement. Encouragement needs no talent. I will simply mention, speak about these 5 things that I think you need them, and you don't have to say awuziphiwanga, azifuni fuzo, azifuni sibabalo, azifuni ntambiso. Zizinto that you can develop within yourself. You know, they require no talent. Let me begin at the first one, the one I've said, it's teachability. Teachability is the desire to listen, the desire to learn, the desire to apply. Listen, learn, and apply. That is what we call teachability. Yes, amen. You know, they know enough who know how to learn. Let me just give you quickly what I call thoughts about teachability. Because number one, there is nothing that is interesting. Nothing on earth that is interesting if you are not interested. I have caused people to listen to a clip from someone. I regard the clip to be so inspiring. It causes me to be what inside. But when I share it to someone, they look at me and say, I'm Anuan Bambese, because what is interesting to me is not interesting to that particular person. That is why I say nothing is interesting if you are not interested. My best friends are my best teachers, the people that have inspired me with a lot of stuff that when I listen to them, I feel that I am taught beyond any capability to contain. You know, I want to tell you that make your friends your teachers and mingle the pleasure of conversation with the advantage of instruction. So when you gather with people, when you separate, have 2-3 things that you have learned from the talk. Don't while away talk. And all that kind of stuff. Make your friends your teachers and mingle the pleasure of the conversation with the advantage of instruction. Because successful people view learning differently than those who are less successful. That is what I've noticed early in life. But they see teaching ngendlela eyahlukileyo ebantwini abangaphumeleliyo. You know, because I'll tell you, a winner knows how much that he still has to learn, even when he is considered by a lot of other people as an expert. Because there are times when people, when they listen to you, they say, wow, you are such an expert. And you don't get puffed up because of those comments. You know, if you are a winner, you know that you still have to learn, even when other people are considering you as an expert. You know, a loser is a person who wants to be considered an expert by other people before he has learned enough to know how little that he knows. Because the funny thing about knowledge, the more you know, the more you know that you know very little, you know, and you feel that, wow, there is very little I know, when other people consider you to know quite a lot. You know, look for and plan your teachable moments. In other words, empty the coins of your purse into your mind, and your mind will fill your purse with coins. I normally say these things to people who are not interested to spend their funds for something that will actually add value and causes them to grow. People would not share, would not feel that they are to invest in their intellectual growth, in their spiritual growth, in their they will always be poorer no matter what they do. And it is for that reason I'm telling you that begin to empty your pocket, drain your purse into your mind, and you'll be surprised. Your mind will begin to fill your purse. Make your teachable moments count. Live to learn, and you will really learn to live. If you live to learn, you will really, really learn to live. Allow me to say something more. You know, the second thing I said, it needs no talent. One of us has a Balapekaban Jamele Bonke, a man of a Kitapa Pam, one by one. Now, Kumandilaki is going to come between 5 and 6 next week when I come on this show. The Daubandi Stiga Gula Maza, Daubandi Abela Pesgo Mandlake, Kuba Epuma, Selemtara Eambile Ulesta, Nospogi Njengo Gumizalo, Namlaje. All right, yes, okay. Niambona Guloza, Sibana, right throughout. And I've told you that when I leave the studio next week, there will be an angel sitting on this chair to take us straight directly to heaven. Wait for that moment. Now, secondly, another thing that needs no talent is called initiative. It is called initiative. To succeed, jump as quickly at an opportunity, just as you do at completion. Yes, if you really are eager to win, because the world that we are living in, the world bestows its prizes, both its money and its honors, on one thing. That is initiative. Let me tell you, people who get money in this world are the people who are initiative. People who receive awards in this world are the people who are initiative. People who are hailed as heroes are the people who take initiative. Amen. You can ask me a question, what is initiative? I will tell you, it is doing the right thing without being told. But next to doing the thing without being told is doing it when you have been told once. I know I'm making sense to some who are listening with both of their ears. Those who can carry a message get high honors, but their pay is not always in proportion. Next, there are those who never do a thing until they are told twice. Such get no honors, and they receive a very small thanks. Next, there are those who do the right thing only when an executive kicks them from behind. And these get indifference instead of honors and pittance for their pay. Now, the kind spends most of its time polishing the bench with a hard luck story. Now, then still lower down the scale than this, we have a dullard who will not do the right thing even when someone goes along to show him how and stays to see he does it. He's always out of a job and receive the contempt he deserves unless he happens to have a rich father, in which case destiny patience awaits around the corner with an iron club. To which class do you belong of these people that I've spoken about? Ndibona ke tana uMabusi uNtondini. I don't know noba usese Joburg noba is back to East London, but welcome Mabusi. I'm glad to see you on my show today, and I believe that the Lord is still with you, empowering you, and walking the journey with you. I was checking other people on the screen here who are with us. All right. Let me continue saying something about this initiative that I spoke about. Initiative. Accept responsibility for your own life. Because I will tell you, lack of responsibility is equal to lack of initiative. The people who get on in this world are the people who get up and look for the circumstance that they want. And if they can't find them, they make them. These are the people who get on ahead of us in this world. I must tell you quickly, when I speak of initiative, that discover your dream and pursue it, you know. Because South Africa, in the eyes of the world, typifies above all else this quality of initiative. The great success are nearly all the fruit of initiatives. Divide your dream into manageable parts. Overwhelmed people seldom take initiative. That's the greatest problem, Ntakantondini, that destroys most people. Let me just quickly train you on how to break down your big projects. Divide them by categories. Prioritize them by importance. Timeline them by their sequence. Assign it by their abilities and accomplish it by teamwork, understanding the downside of no initiative, because this may come to those who wait, but only the things left by those who hustle will come to those who wait. Therefore, the only biggest advice I can give you this evening is cause something to happen. Oh man, please listen to me. Cause something to happen. Zixelele uba makube khona into eyenzekayo ke ngoba uyayenza uba mayenzeke. You know, let me speak on passion very quickly, because I think this can inspire you too. Passion, because success is not the result of spontaneous combustion. Noma ngubani owakhe watsho loo nto kuwe. Success is not a result of spontaneous combustion. You must first set yourself on fire. Siqiniseke uba uyazi-illuminate ngepalafini, utshe, uvuthe. Then you are bona impumelelo ngenxa yokukutsha kwakho. If you don't, then forget about the next move. You know, let me tell you some few things about passion. I will run on them as they quickly come into my mind. Beware of those people whom I call firefighters. There are people in your life or around you who I call firefighters. When it comes to passion, there are two kinds of people, firelighters and firefighters. And you need to stay away from the firefighters. And I will tell you why must you run his tende, must better snaini ubaleka I firefighters. You know, firefighters focus on what is wrong with an idea than what is right. Firefighters possess a doubting spirit. Firefighters work behind the scenes to cause your dissension. Basoloko be work out I downfall yako I firefighters. Firefighters hate change. Bafuna into zihlale zinjeya bayacaphuka ukuba ngathi into zizawuguquka. Firefighters love the words yes, but. Those are firefighters. Firefighters keep people with great potential from going to the top. Ngabaqinezeli bayamkinzelela umntu ongathi angenyuka. Prioritize your life according to your passion. I'm still on the subject of passion as something that needs no talent. Prioritize your life according to your passion, because there are many things that will catch my eye, but there are only a few that catch my heart. It is those things that I consider to pursue. Now, passion is the first step to achievement. Find your passion and follow it. That is the only career advice that you will ever need from me. If you want me to advise you career-wise, I will tell you with no shadow of doubt, find your passion and then begin to pursue it. That is the greatest career that advice I can give you. Passion is the first step to achievement. You know, yes, because the first thing is to love your sport. Never do it to please someone else. It has to be yours. If you love what you do, let me tell you honestly, you will never work another day in your life because you are loving what you are doing. Passion is the fuel for vision, because if vision in passion, with no passion, your vision is going nowhere. Vision does not ignite growth. Passion does. Passion fuels vision, and vision is the focus of power. It is the focus of the power of passion. Leaders who are passionate about their call, they create vision. Have you ever noticed the difference that passion makes? How many dispassionate successes have you ever met? How many high achievers that lack enthusiasm? How many great leaders do you admire who are indifferent? How, you know, passion opens the door for achievement. When you are passionate about what you are doing, commitment naturally follows. You wake up early at night because what you are doing, it fires you up. You are passionate about it. That is why you will definitely push the borders. You don't have to try to produce perseverance. It sweeps over you like an ocean wave. Passion turns your have-tos into wants-tos.
It creates a fire for motivation that never goes out. People with passion enjoy climb. As much as they enjoy reaching the summit. If you have passion, you will never need a jump start. In fact, you never have to push yourself to a start. If anything, you must force yourself to stop. Because passion causes you to run endlessly. It gives you zillions and zillions of energy that causes you to feel like if it is possible, the 24 hours is too little for you to keep on working. You can add another hour to make a day longer than 24 hours because of passion. You know, yes, yes. In fact, you never have to push yourself, but you just keep on. Passion will keep you going when the chips are down. Passion will keep you going when the odds are high. Passion will keep you going when the obstacles are many. Passion will keep you going when the resources are few. But passion will keep you going. It will keep you going. Let me mention the fourth thing because I'm about to end what I intended to share with you. You know, the fourth thing that needs no talent is courage. Can everybody say with me, courage? Yes, greatness in the last analysis is largely bravery. Courage is escaping from old ideas and old standards and respectable ways of doing things. That is what, according to me, I call courage. You know, courage is an everyday test. I know there are people who are listening to me and that those that will continue listening. The good news about our show, Born to Lead, once you listen, once you never become the same. It transforms you. It changes you. It inspires you. It literally causes you to be somebody you never thought you are. You know, courage. Because greatness in the last analysis is largely bravery. Courage is escaping from old ideas. It is escaping from old standards and respectable ways of doing things. Courage is everyday test because we often think of courage as quality required only in times of great danger or stress. But courage is an everyday virtue that is needed to live a life without regrets. Come on. Why do we need courage? Let me tell you some few things. We need courage in order to seek the truth when we know it may be painful. Because courage is not simply one of the virtues, but it's the form of every virtue at its testing point. We need courage to change when it is easier to remain comfortable. Courage. We need courage to express our conviction when other people challenge us. Because I can tell you that one man with courage is a majority. We need courage to overcome obstacles when progress will come no other way. Let me tell you this. It is not because things are difficult that we do not dare. It is because we do not dare that they are difficult. And Mandela Nowati, it will always look impossible until it is done. Yes, we need courage to learn and grow when it will display our weakness. Because courage is resistance to fear. Courage is a master of fear. Courage is not an absence of fear. No. But it causes you to master fear. You fear even when you have got courage, but you master your fear. We need courage to take the high road when others treat us so badly. Because he who loses wealth loses much. But he who loses friends loses more. But he who loses his courage loses it all. You have lost everything. You know, if you lose your wealth, maybe a quarter of your life is gone. But if you lose your friends, half of your life is gone. But if you lose courage, all of your life is God. You have lost everything. We need courage to lead when being in front makes us an easy target. Because the times when you are in front, you become an easy target. In order for you to lead, you need courage. There is an agonizing loneliness that characterizes the life of a pioneer. Those of us who have started doing something, they know what I'm talking about. Come on, this is Kayla. Yes. Let me mention the fifth one, and that is encouragement. Then I'm done on what I said to teach you today. Let me just mention the last one, and is encouragement. You don't need a talent to have encouragement, because I can tell you this very quickly without any shadow of doubt. Most people don't believe in themselves, because in life it is not what you are that holds you back. It is what you think you are not. That is what holds you back. You are not held back by what you think. You are held back by what you think you are not. You know, a great manager has a knack for making ball players think they are better than they think they are. He forces you to have a good opinion of yourself. He lets you know he believes in you. He makes you get more out of yourself. And once you learn how good you really are, you never settle for playing anything less than your very best. Come on, man. Let me tell you another thing regarding this courage that I'm teaching you about today. Most people have got few, if any, courage. People who believe in them when nobody is there to cheer you on every day, you are likely to feel isolated and discouraged. Keep away from the people who try to belittle your ambitions. Small people always do that, but really great make you feel that you can become great. I hope I'm making sense to someone. You know, let me say in the third place that people know when someone believes in them. They know that. I feel like people know when someone believes in them. Most leaders spend time trying to get others to think highly of them. They portray a kind of an image so that people think of them better. People know when you believe in them. When instead they should try to get their people to think more highly of themselves. It is wonderful when people believe in their leader. It is more wonderful when the leader believes in the people. And the poop in Obasendilele in Dobana, the leader of this radio station, has no confidence in me. He believes in me. He thinks that I do good things. He allows me the space to do that. He believes that I have what it takes to be behind this mic and speak to more than a million people who are listening to us. And because he believes in me. It doesn't matter how other people do, but I keep on coming here because someone believes in me. You can't hold a man down without staying down with him. Now, let me say the fourth thing regarding this courage, you know, because it's also very important. Most people will do anything within their power to embrace leaders' belief in themselves. If others look up to you, then reach down and lift them up. It will change their lives. Reach down and lift them up. It will change their lives. Flatter me, and I may not believe you. Criticize me, and I may not like you. Ignore me, and I may not forgive you. Encourage me, and I will never forget you. Come on, man. That's what I have shared today. Let me just end there, because I want to use 5 minutes sharing the word of God quickly before I leave. But if I could find time, I will talk about other things that do not require talent. For example, the attitude, the character, the values, the self-discipline, the commitment, the responsibility, the servanthood and love. Those things are so important for you to have, and they need no talent at all. But allow me to take the remaining 10 minutes of my time sharing the word of God to you. Amen. I won't even play a song. I will just say to you, this is... Yes. Yes. This is KNR, the radio according to you, and my name is Siza, and we are together. The show is born to lead, but let me speak about, let's go to church, just for the last thing, you know. And before we do that, we'll definitely have to pray. I was taught when I was young to take my head off when we pray. I have to take off my head because I want to pray. Please join me in prayer. Let me check if everything is okay before we end our show. Heavenly Father, we invite you for the remaining 5 minutes of our time, that you take us through the teaching of your word. Let your word sing in our hearts and let it speak to all of us. May it inspire us so that we know exactly why you are going to help us, to empower us, to guard us, to guide us, to walk beside us, to make our journey brighter and to lighten our load as we travel on this journey. Do this so that your name is glorified. My God, I pray in the mighty name of the Lord Jesus the Christ. Let me pick for a topic tonight, the topic that says, be filled with the Spirit. In actual fact, I want to talk about what I call Holy Spirit encounter. Ayikho isubject abantu abaninzi abadla ngokuyichopha, ngokuyimosha, ngokuyikhinzelela kakubi njengesubject kamoya ongcwele. I've seen so many people who choose to make umoya ongcwele a scapegoat of many other atrocities that they want to perform. Bamane beyokusulela kumoya ongcwele. But allow me to read the scripture in the book of Romans, or in the epistle to the Romans, chapter 8, verse 1. I want to pick it from verse 11, Romans chapter 8, verse 11. The Bible says, the Spirit of God who raised Jesus from the dead lives in you. And just as God raised Christ Jesus from the dead, he will give you to your mortal bodies by the Spirit living within you. I'm tempted to read the same verse in Xhosa. EBhayibhileni yesiXhosa iza kuthi, ukuba ke umoya walowo wamvusayo uYesu kwabafileyo umi ngaphakathi kwenu, yena owamvusayo uKristu kwabafileyo uya kuyenza iphile nemizimba yenu enokufa ngaye umoya wakhe omiyo ngaphakathi kwenu. Ndithanda ke ngoku kwincwadi yamaEfes, this is the last scripture I read before I just share some few things and pray. I might continue on this subject until it becomes to sink. I'm just taking the last final run on our show, speaking about the Holy Ghost encounter. In Ephesians chapter 5, verse 18 and verse 19, do not get drunk on wine, which leads to debauchery. Instead, be filled with the Spirit. Speak to one another with psalms, hymns, and spiritual songs. Sing and make music in your heart to the Lord. Let me tell you very quickly in the next few minutes that the Father has heard his work to do. You know, why are living in the age of the Spirit? Why we can say we are living in the age of the Spirit? The time, the dispensation that we are at is called the age of the Spirit. Yes, and I say the Father has had his work to do in creation, because the Bible says the age of the Father extends from the father of all livings, that is Adam, to the father of our faith, that is to Abraham. Yes, that is the age of the patriarchs, of the father. Yes, the son has had his work to do, that is the redemption, because the age of the son extends from the typical sacrifice and the resurrection of the only begotten son of God and son of the Old Testament, Isaac, to the incarnation, death, burial, resurrection, and ascension of the only begotten son of the New Testament and the Lord Jesus the Christ. And these are the reasons why we believe we are living in the age of the Holy Spirit. Yes, the Spirit has his work to do with sanctification, because the age of the Spirit extends from the early rain outpouring at the birth of the church to the final outpouring of the Spirit prior to the Lord's return. We are living in a church age, or the age of the Spirit. I have said why we think and believe that the time we are at is the time of the Spirit, the work of the Spirit in the age of the Spirit. The work of the Spirit is to help bring the fulfillment in the believer, all that has been provided for us by the Father and the Son, and to assist the believer in becoming all that God in Christ has made it possible for us to become. I can quickly, without any shadow of doubt, speak to you about three significant encounters with the Holy Spirit. Three significant encounters with the Holy Spirit. Hey, come on. My talk today is be filled with the Holy Spirit. And if you are so simple, gang over in a ring at the Abatile, a seven or yes, some cool, about kilometers as Nancy, we call her Christ. This is the subject for all of us. This is the food for babies. Yes, three significant encounters with the Holy Spirit. The believer has got three significant encounters with the Holy Spirit that all help the believer to fulfill the destiny. Number one, being born of the Spirit. Number two, being baptized in the Spirit. Number three, being filled in the Spirit. This is my subject tonight. Born of the Spirit, baptized in the Spirit, and filled in the Spirit. These are three different encounters. These are three different fronts. They mean three different things. And I want you to listen to me. The purpose of these encounters is very different from each other. If we are to receive a full benefit of these experiences, we must understand the purpose and the distinction between being born of the Spirit, being baptized with the Spirit, and being filled with the Spirit. Yes, we need to distinguish between each of these three. Let me start with the first one, being born in the Spirit. You know, necessarily for entrance into the kingdom, you need to be born of the Spirit. It's associated with new birth. It occurs when we repent and receive Christ. The Spirit enters into our spirit and we become a child of God and the temple of the Holy Ghost. You know, the evidence that we have been born of the Spirit is the inner witness of the Spirit. The outcome or the fruit of this experience is the growth of the fruit of the Spirit. And the primary focus is the character of Christ. Born of the Spirit yields in you the character of Christ. Now, when I say be baptized of the Spirit, what is that? What will it lead to? What is its primary focus? You know, baptized in the Spirit is an experience that is subsequent to salvation. Not every Tom, Dick, and Harry is baptized with the Spirit. It is after you are saved that you are baptized with the Spirit. It is an endowment with the power from on high to fulfill the commission of God in our lives. Yes, it is an experience that Christ wants every believer to experience. Peter replied, "Repent and be baptized, every one of you, in the name of Jesus Christ for the forgiveness of your sins, and you will receive the gift of the Holy Spirit. The promise is for you and your children and for all who are far off and all whom the Lord of God will call." That is in the book of Acts chapter 2, verse 38 to verse 39. Now, secondly or thirdly or fourthly, whatever that it is, and the baptism in the Spirit is an anointing upon the believer. And fifthly, the baptism in the Spirit is the evidence of this experience is speaking with other tongues. If you have been baptized in the Spirit, you will be able to communicate to God in an unknown language. Yes, the circumstance that believer who had come with Peter were astonished that the gift of the Holy Spirit had been poured out even on the Gentiles, for they heard them speaking in tongues and praising God. Yes. Now, the outcome of the fruit of the Spirit, the outcome or the fruit of this experience is greater release and security to the gifts of the Spirit. And I want to tell you as I close that the primary focus of baptism in the Spirit is the ability or the power of Christ. The power of Christ. Next time I come here, I will speak of to be filled. To be filled. I've been talking about being baptized with the Spirit. I will move and speak of being filled with the Spirit, because I don't want you to confuse in filling with the Spirit with the baptism in the Spirit, because those two are not one and the same. Let me just pray for you for today until we meet next time. Heavenly Father, thank you for the opportunity of sharing your word. And thank you for the truth that you have revealed as we share your word today. Thank you for each and every one of your children that have tuned into KNR and have been part of this. Yes, and I see so many across the globe. Others are listening to us as far off in distant lands. They are listening to us, and may God bless them. May God let them pick up the sense and the meaning of what the Lord is saying through what we are teaching today. May God richly, richly bless all of those who have been part of our show today. Allow me, therefore, to end on that note. In the mighty name of the Lord Jesus Christ, amen and amen and amen. I'll meet you next time. It will be Born to Lead, and I can tell you at what time we will meet. Yes.
Sunday, 6 to 7 p.m.
KNR Radio, according to you.
Radio, according to you. People can listen to us even if they are out in Saudi Arabia, deep in an Islamic country, and the KNR gets in there. It's true to that KNR Inamita. Thank you very much for tuning in today. Let's meet sometime next week. May God bless you. And in us, no bangen dinishia, no Benjamin Dube, no bangen dinishia, and Makendi Tete, no mswake. Atima unkos my sigrid Africa. God bless Africa. Yes, can you enjoy the song?